DC generator. So normally DC generator is a topic from DC machines. In DC machines we will consider DC generators and DC motors, and this is about the construction parts of DC generator and how the parts works and what materials will made of. And first, DC generator is a machine. DC generator is a DC machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. Here the statement is, a machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy is called a DC generator. So normally energy is neither created nor destroyed. It is only transferred from one form to another form. Here the mechanical energy is changed into electrical energy through a machines, and the machine name is DC generator. And working principle of DC generator. So DC generator works on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So it depends on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. So see that whenever a conductor cuts the magnetic lines of force, an EMF is induced in it. So there is a magnetic lines of force, and when we use a conductor and cuts the force in the way by rotating the conductor, we are cutting the magnetic lines of force, then an EMF is induced in it. When the conductor is connected to a circuit, then the current will flow in the circuit. So this is the working principle of DC generator. So for this we use for the magnetic field, we use field windings and field of the DC generator to produce magnetic field, and we use armature to cut that magnetic field. That is here conductor cut that magnetic field. So with the external source we will rotate the armature in the magnetic field which is produced by field windings, then an EMF is induced in it. Next, parts of DC generator, this is related to construction of DC generator. So first, parts: yoke, field windings, armature, commutator, brush, bearings and slip rings. So here are the parts. First one is yoke and side plate. These are used for protection of generator, and these are made up of a material, cast iron or cast steel. So yoke is made up of cast iron or cast steel. Next, field is used to produce magnetic field, and for this we use cast iron or cast steel. And for large machine we use sheet steel laminations. And next, armature. And we know that field is a part that we call as stator, and armature is a part which is called as rotor. And armature core is made up of sheet steel laminations and armature winding. So we have armature winding that is of enameled copper wire. In armature winding there are two types of winding, that is lab winding and wave winding. So lab winding means making the total windings into parallel paths. In lab winding we use equal to the number of poles. So total winding into number of poles. If there are two poles, the total winding is spread as formed into two parallel paths. If there is four poles, it is make as four parallel paths. In wave windings we will form into two parallel paths. Next, commutator. So commutator used to convert DC to AC and AC to DC as per operation. And for commutator, here we use material copper segment with mica insulation. It has insulation that is of mica. And next, a brush. For small machines we use carbon brushes, and for large machines we use copper graphite brushes. Okay. Bearings are placed in front end of the shaft, and these bearings are used to form a smooth rotation of shaft. And bearings are types, gunmetal brush type bearings are used in small machines. Ball or roller bearings are used in medium machines. Babbitt metal brush are used in large machines. Next, slip rings are made up of copper rings. Next, functions of parts of DC generator. So first is yoke and set plates. It gives mechanical support to the pole cores and also serves as a part of magnetic circuits. So yoke gives mechanical support to the pole cores. Pole cores helps to produce magnetic flux. Okay. So it is also related to magnetic field generation, field production. So it serves as a part of magnetic circuit. Next, field coils. So field coils are nothing but stator, and field coils are used to produce the magnetic flux for the machines. And next, in field coils we sometimes use interpoles or commutating poles. So these interpoles or commutator poles are used in the machines to reduce sparking, which is produced at the commutator. Commutator is used to produce a DC output to the alternating EMF in the armature. So DC machine, but we use magnetic field and generate electric EMF. But at the commutator, they didn't receive a DC EMF. So only commutator receives AC EMF, and next commutator convert that AC as DC and gives the DC output. Armature used to induce EMF. Brushes used to make a sliding electrical contact between the armature and the external circuit. So brushes collect the current from armature and it gives to the commutator, and the commutator, so it acts as a sliding electrical contact between the armature and the external circuit. Next, bearings. Bearings are used to support the shaft to rotate it smoothly. And next, slip rings used to connect the external circuit. So, and in these two important points are lap winding is used for large current low voltage machines. Okay. And wave winding is used for low current high voltage machines. So why this means, in lap winding there are more number of parallel paths. It is related to the number of poles. That's why there has larger current and low voltage machine. And here wave winding, there is only two parallel paths. So here low current and high voltage machines. It is used for low current and high voltage machines. Thank you.